Hello guys, welcome to the series Explained. So let's get started. This is a brief about me. And in this lecture of Explained, we will discuss the status of solar energy in India. So in this lecture, we will discuss four areas that what progress India has made in past few years in the area of solar power generation. Then what are the issues that are still left unaddressed, and what is being done to address those issues, and what needs to be done further. And China is a world leader in solar panel manufacturer. So what lessons we can learn from China also, we will see in this lecture. So first thing first, that India has made an immense progress in solar energy generation in past few years. Okay, the unit cost of solar power has also fallen, and solar energy is now competitive with the alternative sources of energy like coal. Okay, so India has expanded its solar generation capacity about 8 times. Okay, so we were generating about 2650 megawatts in May 2014, and it has increased to about 28 gigawatt in March 2019. Okay, and India has also raised its capacity of to about 100 gigawatts, and we have to do it by 2022. So in the comment section below, you can tell that India has actually made a target of generating 175 gigawatts of renewable energy by 2022. So out of 175 gigawatt, 100 is solar. So you can tell in comment section below that what are the other renewable sources of renewable targets of energy that India has made to achieve by 2022. So then, although India is doing so much for in the area of solar power generation, but still there are some issues that are left unaddressed. Okay, so although there is so much focus on solar plant installation, India is still not a solar plant panel manufacturer. We are still not manufacturing solar panels. Okay, so we are still relying on this low cost Chinese imports, and which is also prohibiting the Indian companies from manufacturing our own solar panels. Okay, so we are relying on Chinese imports, and they are so much low cost that Indian companies are not being encouraged to manufacture solar panels in India. Okay, so imports from China has increased from about 86% in 2014 to 90% in 2017. So here you can see also there are several delays in execution of solar projects. Okay, so actually this solar panel manufacturing is having four steps. First is the silicon production from silicate. Silicate means that is sand. We know that earth crust is made up of about 28.7% of silica. Okay, so from this silica we have to produce the silicon. Okay, then the next step is that from this silicon we will produce the solar grade silicon ingots. Okay, then in the next step we will manufacture the solar wafers, and in the final step we will manufacture the photovoltaic module assembly. Okay, so most of the Indian companies are engaged only in this module assembly or wafer manufacturing. The first two step, that is the silicon production step from silicates and the production of solar grade silicon ingots, this is both capital and technologically intensive. So our companies are not so much technologically advanced, and they don't have that much capital that they can engage in these first two steps. Okay, so we are engaged, our companies are engaged only in this module assembly or wafer manufacturing. So what is being done? Okay, what is being done at present for this area, solar energy area? Okay, so in the solar panel manufacturing sector, government is allowing 100% foreign investment as equity, and that too with automatic approval. Means the companies don't have to take any approval from any committees. They 100% foreign investment is allowed. Then the second thing is that government is also encouraging the foreign investors to set up renewable energy based power generation. Okay, and the government is also giving this safeguard duty. Okay, so because of this safeguard duty, the locally made panels can be on par with the imported ones in terms of cost. Okay, so but for this also the domestic sector needs to do a lot more to be effective. Okay, so what it needs to do, it needs to go down the supply chain, and they have to make the input components locally. They don't have to rely on imports. Okay, and they also have to put these modules together locally only. And since they will be making all these components locally, the governments should ensure that they are going to procure all such locally made components by the Indian companies. Okay, so public procurement is also very necessary, because it will assure these companies that whatever they are producing, it will be bought by the government. Okay, so then there are some important lessons that we can learn from China. China is a world leader in this solar panel manufacturing. So first thing is that they have the core competence. Friends, see, before becoming competent in manufacturing solar cells, the Chinese companies became competent in manufacturing semiconductors. Okay, because see, in this previous two slides, we have seen that the first step is extracting silicon from silicate sand, and from this silicon only this semiconductor and microchips are made. So the Chinese companies which first became competent in manufacturing of semiconductors, then they became competent for manufacturing the solar cells. So they have the core competence. So for this, what India can do, the state governments need to support the semiconductor production first, and it is a like time frame of 5 to 10 years when our companies, when they will become competent in manufacturing semiconductor, then they will become competent in manufacturing the solar panel. So first we have to support the semiconductor production in India. And the second source of cost advantage for China comes from government policy. So the Chinese government is heavily subsidizing the land acquisition, raw material, labor and export. So like these kind of subsidization is not being done by the Indian government at present. The third is the cost of capital. The cost of debt in India is about 11%. It is the highest in Asia Pacific region. Means our countries have to pay a lot to get debt. Okay, whereas in China the cost of debt is about only 5%. So the capital is also very costly. Okay, in India. So on these three areas we can learn lessons from China. So what is the way forward in this area? So the way forward is that if we are will go by this approach only, we will become our this solar energy sector will become like our defense sector. In defense sector, you know that India is the second largest importer of weapons all over the world. Okay, so if we will not take appropriate policy measures, India will remain, India's energy sector will become like the defense sector. Okay, where very less indigenization is done at present. Okay, so India needs a solar manufacturing strategy like we had the automotive mission plan. Okay, so automotive mission plan made India one of the largest manufacturers of two-wheelers, three-wheelers, four-wheelers and lorries. Okay, so India needs to have a plan like this for solar manufacturing also. And if they will have a good manufacturing strategy, this will also be a this will also be helpful in generating jobs for our the educated youth of both rural and urban areas. It will also give job opportunities for them. So it will be a win-win situation for everyone. It will also lead to job employment generation also. It will also lead to indigenization also. So we can save our dollars that are being used for imports from China. And it will help the local manufacturing also. So friends, this is it for this lecture. I hope you find this video useful. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.